Tom Brokaw, who is a newscaster, made a statement years ago after the World War II Memorial was built in Washington, D.C., talking about the World War II veterans. He went on to say that they are the world's greatest generation. And indeed, he was right. But today, we want to honor not only World War II veterans, but all veterans, but today, we have a special four guests that we would like to say a few words about, and all World War II veterans. But even though we honor these four today, we honor all World War II veterans during this special ceremony.
First, I'd like to say Mr. James Russell Murdoch, born here in Slater, after graduating from Gilliland High School, joined the Army in Portland, North Kansas. After basic training in Camp Stewart, Georgia, went to Fort Hood, Texas for 6 weeks for training. Russell volunteered for duty at Camp in Kansas, where he joined the 1296 Combat Engineers and more training, and his unit boarded a ship in San Francisco, California. For the Philippines, landing on the island of Panay near the city of Iloilo, where they had more training with the 115th Combat Engineers, where they filled the positions previously held by the 115th Unit. All this time, Russell's unit was waiting orders for the invasion of Japan. Due to the atomic bombing of two cities in Japan, the invasion did not happen. Japan surrendered. He served as an administrative NCO of the Philippines unit until his unit was sent back to the United States and was honorably discharged in 1946.
Jim Mendenhall. Jim was born in Miami, Missouri, 1925, attended high school here in Slater. Shortly after graduation, 1943, entered the United States Army 81st Infantry Division at Fort Leavenworth, Kansas. Jim fought in the jungles of the South Pacific Islands and in the Philippines. After the atomic bombs were dropped on two cities in Japan, Japanese were forced to surrender. His division landed north of Hiroshima to secure that area. Jim returned to the United States via Los Angeles, returned to Slater. The Daughters of the American Revolution in September of this year nominated Jim as Patriot of the Month, Jim Mendenhall.
Communication or regearing.
putting in bricks, Modern Veterans Memorial Site. And after visiting with Ray, I was very intrigued about the Marine Raiders. I never heard of that until I met Ray. And Ray has written a book, My 3 Years in the Marine Corps. So now I'm going to write a book about my time in the Navy. It won't be a bestseller like his is, but anyway, it's very interesting. It's a great book. Anyway, here are our letters to his sweetheart, Helen, from Sweet Springs. After Ray came home, he married Helen. Helen, please stand. Jack Sandy. Jack was born in Baxter Springs, Kansas. He was in the United States Army from 1943 to 1945. He served as a light 30 caliber machine gunner and an expert rifleman. During his combat service, Jack served the following campaigns: D-Day, the Normandy landings at Omaha Beach, the Rhineland, Northern France, Central Europe, the Battle of the Bulge, and the crossing of the Rhine River into Nazi Germany. Sam Griffin and his unit were the spearhead attached to the 6th Engineer Special Brigade that landed on Omaha Beach 15 minutes before the first wave of the invasion. His unit's mission, like Ray's, was to clear of any obstacles for the other troops to land. Jack was wounded on the beach, but continued his support and his objective. He was wounded a second time, crossing the Rhine, and was hospitalized for 11 months, which he was awarded the Purple Heart, along with other medals. Jack Sandler.